Greetings to everyone out there, and welcome back to Around the Clock. Alright everyone, new evidence has surfaced that confirms Mario Kart Crossroads for the Nintendo Switch is happening. Now, this information comes from well-known video game analyst and the CEO of Ketten Games, Dr. Serkan Toto. He's recently shared his predictions for the video game industry in 2022 with GamesIndustry.biz. A lot of you may know about Dr. Serkan Toto with all of the bold predictions that he made about the Switch Pro releasing in 2021. Of course, we did not get a Switch Pro in 2021, but instead the Switch OLED was introduced. But still, all of his other predictions for 2021 did happen, and he's made some other bold predictions in the past years that came to pass as well. So the information that he shares cannot be ignored. With that being said, let's take a look at his 2022 predictions for Nintendo. As you can see here, Nintendo announces Mario Kart 9 and a new mobile game. I am aware, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe is still selling very well on the Nintendo Switch, but Mario Kart 9 is in active development and comes with a new twist, and Nintendo could tease it this year. On mobile, Nintendo has been very silent since Mario Kart Tour's launch in 2019, but I think 2022 is when we see an established IP arriving on smart devices again. So, as you can see here, Dr. Serkan Toto is making it clear that yeah, Mario Kart 9 is in active development and this game could be teased this year, maybe at E3, at a random Nintendo Direct, or sometime at the end of the year. And also, a brand new mobile game for Nintendo could be released in 2022 as well. Now, to back up what he had to say about this brand new Mario Kart game, well-known insider Leaky Pandy had this to say earlier this week. New games expected to be revealed this year, heard of. From Nintendo, a brand new Xenoblade side game which is action slash adventure. Rogue Squadron 4, developed by Crytek. Mario Kart 10 slash Crossroads, been exposed to both names. Unsure of Final 1, features multiple IP, and finally, a Pikmin title developed by Next Level Games. Now, I do want to make it clear that both Leaky Pandy and Dr. Serkan Toto did state that these games will be revealed this year and not released, so let's keep that in mind. Now, also, Leaky Pandy had this to say when asked, Mario Kart 10, but what happened to 9? And they state, it stands out, right? Supposedly, it's a play on words on the fact that the game goes beyond and introduces more Nintendo characters. So that could be the reason why Dr. Serkan Toto stated that this game has a new twist, introducing more Nintendo characters with more vehicles and things like this, almost like a Smash Ultimate version of Mario Kart. Alright, now, I know a lot of people out there may be thinking, yeah, this sounds good and all, but Mario Kart 8 Deluxe is still selling so well for the Switch. Why would they introduce a brand new game for the Switch? Well, let's think about this. We also have The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild and Splatoon 2 that are both evergreen titles that are still selling extremely well for the Switch, and still, Nintendo is releasing Splatoon 3 and The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild 2 this year in 2022. So, just because a game is selling well doesn't mean that they can't make a sequel or another addition to that game and release it years later. So, all in all, we'll just have to wait and see what happens, but man, we've been hearing so much about this brand new Mario Kart game that it seems like it is true. Alright everyone! That's going to do it for this video. What are your thoughts on everything that was discussed here? Please let me know down in the comment section. Also, check out my affiliate links down in the description box below to bestbuy.com. If you make a purchase through any of those links, I will receive a small commission with no extra cost to you, which goes to supporting this channel, so consider doing so if you're interested. And please, like this video, share this video, and subscribe to the channel if you're not already subscribed. And as always, remember to keep it locked here at Around the Clock, where here, we focus on Nintendo news content around the clock. I'll catch you guys in the next one.